What's up guys, ShangHealy1247 here. Today I'm bringing you a quick review of the Halo Megablocks 2013 set UNSC Light Assault VTOL or VTOL. As I said, this is one of the new 2013 summer sets, and it's one of two Reap X series sets. For those of you who don't know, Reap X is basically a secret branch of ONI that develops new vehicles, weapons and researches for Covenant and the aliens species in the Covenant. And also, the VTOL is basically stands for Vertical Takeoff and Landing Craft. It's a heavily armoured, fully mobile combat flyer designed to operate in confined environments, and it has three turbines to allow the vehicle to navigate through narrow spaces. So let's jump into it now. First of all, in the box, you get two things other than the set and the instructions. An advertisement for the Blox Brigade. The two things that are interesting on here, before I'm showing it to you, is hints at the new Operator and Pathfinder armour, and I believe you can get those in the Pelican, which I will definitely be getting. It looks an awesome set. Also, you get a sort of card with like blueprints for the VTOL. Looks really, really awesome. And there you've got the Reap X logo down there. On the back, you've got more info about the vehicle itself. And then, as you can see, this set includes one vehicle and two figures. I will just say this set is retailed at about £20 in the UK, which for those of you in America is $30. Now, to me, that just seems ridiculous because, I mean, yeah, it's a cool set, but I mean, for the amount of stuff you're getting one small vehicle, one small sort of medium vehicle, and two figures. I know it's new, but that's it. I'd have liked to have seen this at about £15. Or maybe 17 at the highest, but 20 is just too much, to be honest. I did still buy it though, just because I wanted to get this review out, and also the set does appeal to me, although the price is too high in my opinion. Anyway, moving on, let's start off with the figures here. First of all, we have one of two brand new figures. This is the Storm Jackal. Really, really awesome. I love this. I love this enemy in the Halo 4 of the game, but I think they've done a really good job of it, especially the head sculpt. Just looks so game accurate, so awesome. It looks more sort of meaty, muscular than the normal Jackal. A lot more badass, I think. My favourite part of this as well is the back. The armour on the back is really, really cool. As you can see there, it's got the sort of plates down the spine. Just looks really, really cool. The only differences in that I can see so far from the normal Jackal mould, the arms are a little bit different, I believe, slightly less feathers, and you've got these wristbands. The torso is completely different, I think, with this new armour, as I said. The legs are very similar, if not the same, and then the head is different. So really, really cool figure. He comes with some brand new weapons as well. This is the brand new Halo 4 beam rifle. Really, really awesome. That's the right way up. Lots of moulded detail there. Lots of people are saying, oh, this isn't a painted version, but there's actually some paint. As you can see there on the trigger piece, I think that's the trigger piece anyway, there's like a blue dot either side. So very, very cool. And for those of you who don't know, I was expecting this to be more of a purple. It is actually blue. It is a dark navy blue. And then you also get a standard yellow Jackal shield. Although I'm not sure if we've seen yellow before. I haven't had that many Jackals, so I'm not sure. But usually they're either red or blue or purple, I think. But this one is yellow. Moving on next, we have a DMR. In grey, very nice detailing again on this, no paint but nice moulding. This is for the Spartan here. Let's just grab him. Oops. Here he is. The Spartan here, which I'm really, really pleased with Megablocks for using the new visor colours instead of just the standard gold, which in Halo 4 isn't really the standard colour, it's the blue one, which is the first one you unlock, but whatever. But really, really cool. I forget which visor this actually is. I think it may be Bloodshot, but don't hold me to that. But this is a red visor, looks really awesome on this figure. And this figure is sporting the what appears to be the standard colour scheme for the new Reap X figures, which is the navy blue and silver, which actually looks really, really nice. On the back, loads of painted and moulded detail as usual with these new Megablocks figures. Look at that on the back, looks absolutely awesome, exceptionally game accurate. Just, you can't really go wrong with this figure, really cool. Now we'll move on to the main piece of this set, which is the VTOL or VTOL, however you wish to say it. Basically, starting off, I guess, the main parts of this set. You have the cabin, the sort of cockpit here, where a figure can happily be seated, hold onto the joysticks there. Then to the left and right you have two symmetrical or identical turbine pieces that do have a range of movement. They go up to about that much and down to about that much. And on each one is mounted a sort of heavy machine gun, very similar to that of the siege bike, which is mounted on the side. So they're mounted sort of under the wings. Very cool. And then again, same sort of turbine deal on the right hand side. So really nice. As I said, movability in that, good for stop motions and displays. Then at the back you have a slightly different turbine piece, has a little less movement. It's almost exactly the same except for this bit up here. So that's the main bits of the set. Really, really nice. I like this vehicle a lot. To start with, I didn't like the design with the sort of open cockpit. I thought that was a bit odd. But it sort of grows on you the more you look at it. I actually think it's quite nice now. The figures do look very nice seated in there. I think this is a really great thing. I wonder if this vehicle will be in Halo 5. Leave your thoughts on that in the comments. That'd be cool to know what you guys are thinking. Personally, I think it may be. Depends on the storyline. As I said, this is Repex. I don't know whether that'll play a significant part in Halo 5 or not. Or whether it's just been sort of conjured up by 343 for Megablocks to use. I don't know. But at the moment, all I know is that these new vehicles, the Repex sets, are very nice in my opinion. So guys, that's pretty much it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do drop a like for these new 2013 sets. As I said, I believe this is the first UK review out, which I'm really pleased with. If you haven't already, please do subscribe and also check out my other videos. I've currently got the Series 7 opening and review up on my channel and also a Siege Bike review. So thanks a lot, guys, and I hope you enjoyed the video.